Naalala ko po yung Magna Carta for Public School Teachers. It's an old law enacted in 1966, some 58 years ago. Doon nakalagay po yung maraming benefits sa mga teachers. Meron po doon na cost of living allowance. Ang sabi po doon, at least the teacher's salary should keep in pace with the living expenses, and the allowance should be given and be based automatically on the living cost index. On an annual basis, the Secretary of Education should submit to Congress, ang sabi po doon, a recommendation for an appropriation for this cost of living expenses. Nangyayari po ba yun sa inyo? Meron pa pong sinasabi na special hardship allowance. Ito po ay yung pong exposure ninyo to difficult situation from commuting to your assignments and other exposures. Ang sinasabi po doon, you should be paid at least 25% of your monthly salary. Nangyayari po ba yun? Meron pa pong sinasabing medical examination and medical treatment which should be given free to all teachers. At kapag ka doon sa medical examination napatunayan meron kayong sakit, you will be treated for free. Nangyayari mo ba ito? Sana po darating ang araw makasama ko si Senator Win Gatchalian para kaming dalawa po, by the oversight function of the Senate, titingnan po natin mabuti kung napatutupad na mabuti ang Magna Carta for Public School Teachers. Ang sinasabi po kasi, the declaration of policy is to promote and improve the social and economic status of public school teachers, their living and work conditions, including the requirements for employment and career prospects. 58 years after the enactment of the law, we have yet to fulfill the realization of this declared policy. Kaya kailangan po siguro, total nandiyan naman si Senator Win, baka sakali pong magkita naman kami sa susunod na Senado. Meron pa pong isang sinasabi about teachers. A good education can change anyone. May I propose a little amendment? A good education can change anyone, but not everyone. Alam po niyo kung bakit? Tingnan po niyo yung mga colleagues ko sa House of Representatives. I thought they had good education. I thought they were all taught by good teachers like you. I believe they have valued all our laws and our traditions, as the teachers always say during our years of education. Pero tingnan ninyo yung nangyari. I was only defending our rules in the House of Representatives. I was only defending the traditions that make us all, because these traditions are the ones that we kept for so long a time. These are time-honored traditions that cannot just be discarded, cannot be erased. The office of the Vice President is not subjected to questions, and that is the well-kept tradition. Eh ano pong gagawin natin? Huwag po kayong mag-alala. Marami naman po kayong tinuruan, mas marami po yung magagaling kesa dun sa mapupuro lang ulo. Hindi na po ako magtatagal because we have a flight to catch up. Ang sasabihin ko lamang po sa inyo, kayo pong mga teachers, na alam ko po ang buhay nyo sapagkat ang aking may bahay ay katulad ninyo, I implore that you continue to be heroes. I came here not only to celebrate with you. I came here not only to pay tribute to you. But I came here to seek your solace, your guidance, and your inspiration to what is happening in the House of Representatives. Huwag po kayong mag-alala. Yung itinuro po nyo sa inyong magagaling na estudyante will be kept forever in our hearts. And we will fight whatever it takes. I'd like to end by saying this to the people of the municipality of Caraga and to the rest of the people of Mindanao. Gikan sa akong kasing-kasing, gihigugma ko kamong tanan. Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause once again to Honorable Dante Marcoleta.